In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create automatic animated subtitles in Premiere Pro. Let's get to it. Begin by adding audio to the timeline, then go up to Window, make sure you have the text window enabled, then open the text window, go into Transcript, and here you should find all of the audio files that you have on your timeline. So if you expand the arrow, make sure you check the ones that you want to transcribe, and then click Transcribe. Then the transcript will be created from the audio, and before we convert the transcript into actual captions, make sure you go through the text and correct any possible mistakes. And after you're happy with it, go into Captions tab and click Create Captions from Transcript. Then this tiny window will show up, make sure you expand the arrow, and here you'll find a few important settings that will influence the subtitles. Now you get the ability to set the maximum length in characters for your subtitles. If you want the subtitles to be one or two words at a time, make sure you decrease this all the way down to 7, and also you get the ability to set the minimum duration of the subtitle, so let's decrease that also. And you also get the option to choose single or double line captions, so we're going with single. Then click Create Captions. Then a separate track will be added to the timeline just for the subtitles. And to adjust all of them at once, we're going to go up to Window and make sure you have the Essential Graphics enabled. Then in the Essential Graphics, go into Edit tab. Then on the timeline, click and drag to select all of the subtitles. And then in the Essential Graphics, go ahead and adjust the text to your liking, change the font, size, and stuff like that. And after you're happy with how the text looks, we can proceed to animating our subtitles. But first, we need to convert them into text layers. And the way we do that is by dragging and selecting all of them on the timeline, then go up to Graphics and Titles and select Upgrade Caption to Graphic. Now the subtitles have been converted to the actual text layers, and this allows us to add any type of animation to them. Let's add a pop-up effect. For this, let's open the effects window and search for Transform. Then add it to the first text layer. Select it and open the effect controls panel. And before we add any animation, let's select the transform effect. Then you should see the blue indicator in the preview window. Let's click and drag it, holding shift to the position where our text was. And as we do that, the text will move. That is completely fine. And then move the other indicator as well and place it accordingly. And we do this so that when we add the pop effect, we want the animation to happen from the center of the text instead of the center of the sequence. Now let's create a keyframe for scale by clicking on the stopwatch icon. Then set scale to 75. Make sure you do this at the beginning of the text layer. Then move 3 frames forward, 1, 2, 3. Then set scale to 125. Move another 3 frames forward, 1, 2, 3. And reset scale back to 100. Then uncheck use composition shutter angle and increase it to 360 to add motion blur. Now we've added the pop effect to the first text layer. Now we can simply select the transform effect, press Ctrl C to copy it, then select the rest of the text layers and press Ctrl V. Now all of the text layers will have the same pop-up effect. And if we do the preview here, we have the automatic animated subtitles. Thank you guys for watching.